So, are they all living happily ever after? On Monday night, TLC premiered the latest season of 90 Day Fiancé, giving viewers an update on the couples it has introduced over the years on this controversial reality show. Which relationships are in great shape? Which are in tatters? And which has one half hoping the other side gets deported? Let's find out, shall we? Jorge and Anfisa. The premiere opened with Jorge complaining because Anfisa doesn't have a job. Shockingly, it turns out that Jorge isn't exactly as rich as TLC has hyped him up to be. The guy can't even afford to move the couple out of their tiny apartment. In response to her partner complaining, Anfisa says she won't cook. She'd prefer if they just went out to restaurants all the time. But that's expensive. The issues simply extend from there. Jorge swears his medical marijuana business has a bright future, but Anfisa feels that he hasn't delivered on the financial promises he made back when the two met online. Jorge thinks she's controlling. He says she's broken his phones and the key to his car and it sucks that she can't drive as a result of green card status. I hate being married to Jorge, Anfisa says at one point. Once she gets her green card, I'll be free, she adds. After Jorge finally admits that he's $30,000 in debt, blaming his fiscal difficulties on all the time he's spent with his new wife, Anfisa demands a post-nuptial agreement and storms out. Chantal and Pedro. On the flip side, these two are in a great place. Chantal is getting better at cooking and Pedro, who recently was granted a green card, has found work both in a warehouse and as a dishwasher. Chantal would like the couple to spend some more time with her family is all, although Pedro makes it clear he isn't all that comfortable around Chantal's parents. What about a wedding in the Dominican Republic to bring both families together, she suggests. Oh, and how about a prenuptial agreement? They talk to Pedro's mom about that on the phone. And she does not have nice things to say about Chantal in response. Loren and Alexi. Coming off of their wedding in Israel, these two meet up with Loren's parents for lunch. Loren says she's been having a challenging time finding a job and wishes that she'd moved Alexi to New York. However, Alexi is perfectly content to remain in Florida and thinks that she his wife is a tad bit selfish because he was the one that moved for her already. She has to make the most of where they are not somehow make Alexi feel like the couple made a mistake. Loren says that she hasn't seen Sarah in about a year or two and wants to spend a weekend with her in New York. Fortunately, Loren does get a chance to speak to Sarah later on and plan a trip to the Big Apple. But she's still suspicious of Alexi's bachelor party. Danielle and Mohammed. With the internet abuzz of Mohammed's whereabouts, Danielle made it pretty clear she's only interested in payback. I want to get him deported, she said on the premiere, explaining. It's been months since I've seen him, and I am starting to move on from him. I'm going back to college, and I'm looking for a nicer home for me and my daughters, and I even have a new boyfriend. Mohammed, meanwhile, says that after Danielle found his address, he knew he had to get the heck out of Miami. Therefore, he moved to Port Richey and has been working as a driver. In the most dramatic scene of the premiere, Mohammed was served papers for annulment. If this goes through, he really could get deported, prompting Mohammed to call his estranged wife. But what does Danielle say in response? Basically, tough luck, loser. Paola and Russ. We end on Paola and Russ. She's still living in Miami and he's still in Oklahoma, with Paola meeting with her agent at one point to see how she can further her career. Go blonde is the response, which leads Paola to get a $450 Diane-style job that she loves. She later meets up with Juan, a friend of hers from childhood, and his boyfriend, talking to them about how she felt depressed in Oklahoma. Juan isn't a big fan of Russ and says that just hearing him speak makes him tired. Paola finds out that friends in Colombia discuss how she and Russ simply don't fit together, causing her to question their relationship. She eventually calls him and he tells her that he misses her. But Payala doesn't seem to reciprocate this feeling. Will these two still be together when the season concludes?